الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على أشرف المرسلين سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. Again, ليلة القدر. It's not the end of ليلة القدر. It's not the 27 of Ramadan. A lot of people, they focus on the 27 of Ramadan, which is, there is a hadith, there is sihah, but some ulama, they say, ليلة القدر. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he says, seek it in the last 10 days of Ramadan. And the last 10 days of Ramadan can be the 30s, from the 21st, and then he said the odd days. And then even the odd days, which is the 21st, the 23rd, the 25th, the 27th, or the 29th, these are the odd days of the last 10 days. Sometimes we don't know if we fast this Ramadan on the exactly the first day or not. So even these odd days, so the word seeking on the last days, the general hadith, إِلْتَمِسُوهَا فِي الْعَشْرِ الْأَوَاخِرِ مِنْ رَمَضَانِ. It's better for you, to be honest with you, and safe. And the ulama, oh, mashallah, something pops in my mind. One shaykh, wallahi, I like this ulama. They think. He says, why you are seeking only on the 27th? And the Prophet ﷺ, he's giving you 10 days. He says, imagine somebody gives you, he says, I will give you a palace. And he gives, okay, but the key of that palace is on this 10 key. He gives you the whole, but take one, are you going to take one key or are you going to take the whole thing? He gives you, take the whole 10, and when you go to the palace, try one of them. Eventually, you're going to open the palace, the door. The door will be open because you get the ten keys. But some people, they want, oh, no, this is the key. And then they go, and they want to know if it's not the right key. So this is exactly like what we do. Take the whole 10 days. So now, the reason I said this, because we made an announcement for Laylatul Qadr, Khatm al-Qur'an. This is another wrong concept. The Khatm al-Qur'an is the people disappear from the masjid. And I remember, because I'm speaking from experience. The minute we say Khatm al-Qur'an, the people, they come on the 27th, Salamu alaykum, Salamu alaykum. What is the 28th? He's not there. 29th, brothers, where are you going? No, please come to every, like you finished the 10 days. I mean, you know, this is the beauty of it. And that's, inshallah, we will mention more about it. The Prophet ﷺ, he loves his wife Aisha radiallahu anha. This is connected to Laylatul Qadr. He loves Aisha so much. And how it's connected to Laylatul Qadr, his wife. She asked him, Ya Rasulullah. Even his wife, she used to call him Ya Rasulullah. This is respect. She didn't say, oh my husband, oh Muhammad. No. Allah said, do not call Muhammad by his name. Call him Rasulullah. Muhammadun Rasulullah. Out of respect. So even the Aisha, she said, Ya Rasulullah, if I was happened to be on Laylatul Qadr, what should I say? Wallahi, it's amazing. And the Prophet ﷺ loves his wife Aisha radiallahu anha. There is a mutable, now he's going to give an advice to someone that he loves so much. He says, Ya Aisha, if you happen to catch Laylatul Qadr and see and be on Laylatul Qadr, say this dua. إن اللهم إنك عفو تحب العفو فاعف عني. والله to be honest with you, this dua is amazing. I went, I did research. The Prophet ﷺ didn't say, Ya Aisha said, Ya Allah, إنك غفور تحب المغفرة فاغفرني. Because what's the difference between مغفرة with Allah غفور رحيم and also عفو. غفور and عفو, you have to know the difference. I never know this difference until it shook me. The difference between Afu and Ghafur. That's why the Prophet ﷺ, he didn't give her the, you know, like the VIP dua. Afu is VIP, is like the highest level of dua. I'll give you an example, I don't want to take too much time. Ghafur, it means Allah will forgive your sin and the marks still there. The malaika, they still know that brother did something. But Allah forgive it. Allah knows that you did something haram, you steal something, you did something, and you ask maghfirah, and you did tawbah, Allah will raise it. But the mark, you know, sometimes you raise something, and the mark stay there. You polish something, the mark still there. Afu is no mark stays. See the difference? Afu, Allah will forgive the sin, and He remove it from the malaika's books. The malaika will not never know. Listen to this, wallahi. Allah will remove it from the earth. If you have done anything bad on this earth, and you happen to, Allah happened to accept this dua, عفا عنك, it means he removed it from the heart of the people. The people will never remember you did something wrong to them. You know what I'm saying? You see, it's amazing. He removed it from the earth. It means he removed the sin and the atar, the marks of the sin. This is the difference. Ghafoor, he removed the sin and the atar stay there. That's why the Prophet ﷺ gives you, this is amazing. Allah, what do you want? Even the people that you have done wrong with them, and then you happen to, Allah happen to accept your afu, afa anka, from that particular sin, the people will not remember that you did something. Oh yes, salam alaykum. He will never. But if Allah just forgive you, so the brothers still remember you did something wrong to them. You see, it's a big difference. That's why the Prophet ﷺ, when his beloved wife, she says, Ya Rasulullah, give me an advice. He says, say, Allahumma innaka afuun. Tuhibbul afu. Allah loves to remove the sin and the mark. This is the beauty of Allah. It's not like a human being. They say, I forgive you, but he said, hey, remember, you did this and this. Allah even wants to remember. He will remove it from your own brain. He will remove it from your heart that you don't even remember that sin. So may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, اللهم إنك عفو تحب العفو فاعف عنا. سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين جزاكم الله خير. السلام عليكم. You can start paying zakat al-fitr from now, because the masjid will give the zakat al-fitr 2 days. Like Abdullah ibn Umar, he used to give zakat al-fitr 2 days before Salat al-Eid. والسلام عليكم. Yes.